All of you please type your attendance. In our previous class, we had discussed about construction of quadrilateral. In how many ways we have learned the construction of quadrilateral? Four ways. And first way was when four sides and one diagonals are given. And in the second case, what we have done in our second case? What we have done is when two diagonals and three sides are given. And after that, we have discussed about when two adjacent sides and three angles are known. At last, when three sides and two included angles are given. In the four, in the all four cases, we have discussed previously. And now we have some special cases. Let's check what was our special cases. In page number 67, you can see that to draw a quadrilateral, we used five measurements in our work. Is it? We have used five measurements. That is either four side, one diagonal, three side, two angles, or three angles, two sides. We have used in either case, we have used five measures. If there is any quadrilateral which can be drawn with less number of available measurements? That was our question. Is there is any quadrilateral which can be drawn with less number of available measurements? The following examples examine such special cases. That is, we have to draw a square of side 4.5 centimeter. For drawing a square, we only have to get the measure of one side, because we know that the measure of each angle should be right angle, that is 90 degree. And if we get any side or measure of any side, we can construct a square. Okay, that is example 5. Draw a square of side 4.5 centimeter. How will you draw a square of 4.5 centimeter? How will you draw? How will you draw a square of side 4.5 centimeter? What is the speciality of diagonal of a square? What is the speciality of diagonal of a square? We have to construct or draw a square of side. Draw a square of side 4.5 centimeter. This is our question. Then I am asking, how will we draw a square of side 4.5 centimeter? Square is a quadrilateral, is it? A square is a quadrilateral. And first of all, we can draw a rough figure. As usual, we can draw a rough figure here. That is, this is a square. What is the length of its side? We can name it
4.5.
As CD. Can name it as ABCD. Then each side will be, how much is the side?
4.5 centimeters.
So each side will be 4.5 centimeter. 4.5 centimeter. Each side will be 4.5 centimeter. Then what is our four angles? What's our four angles? We know that in the case of a square, every angles are right angles. So how will we construct a square? How will we construct a square? First of all, we have to draw either side, is it? That is, Now we are going to draw AB. AB of length 4.5 centimeter. We have just drawn AB of length 4.5 centimeter. Here it is AB. It is 4.5 centimeter and its name is AB. And after that, what we have to do? What we have to do here? We have to make right angles using protractors. So by placing protractor at both A and B, we can mark the right angles. And after that, using compass or either scale, you can make a length of or line of length 4.5 centimeter, which is perpendicular to the line AB in both cases A and B. And after that, we have to join both these two vertices, and this is the square ABCD. Very simple, is it? Very simple, the construction of square. Okay, then similarly, I think you have a doubt regarding to the construction of rhombus. We have a question that we have to do in our previous session, that is construct a rhombus. Next case is the construction of rhombus. That is, the special cases are construction of square and construction of rhombus. Okay, the construction of square is very simple. The solution is also given in your textbook. You don't need to draw it once more, or you can see that is in a textbook. You just remember the way through which we are drawing a square. Okay, then after that, there is another question. Is it possible to construct a rhombus? Is it possible to construct a rhombus? Is it possible to construct a rhombus? A rhombus ABCD, whose name is ABCD. Word AC is equal to 6 centimeter. AC is equal to 6 centimeter, and then BD is equal to 7 centimeter. BD is equal to 7 centimeter. What was our question? Is it possible to construct a rhombus ABCD? AC is equal to 6 centimeter and BD is equal to 7 centimeter. First of all, what we have to do here? As usual, we have to draw a rough figure or a rough sketch. Okay. Then how will you draw the rhombus? What is the speciality of a rhombus? What is the speciality of a rhombus? Rhombus is a special case of parallelogram having all sides equal, is it? All sides equal. So I'm just drawing a, consider this as a rhombus, and I'm going to name it as ABCD. A, B, C and D. So we have the rhombus ABCD. Then what we have given here? AC is equal to 6 centimeter. AC is the diagonal. AC is given as 6 centimeter. The length of its diagonal is equal to 6 centimeter. 6 centimeter. And what about BD? What about BD? BD is the second diagonal and it is given as, and it is given as 7 centimeter. And it is given as, I am just writing here, 7 centimeter. Then do you have any idea of constructing this rhombus? We have only given the length of two diagonals. Then do you have any idea about constructing this rhombus? What is speciality of a diagonals of a rhombus? Speciality of diagonals of a rhombus? What is it? The diagonals are perpendicular bisectors, is it? Is it? We have the exam for our third chapter after finishing this lesson. Okay. We have studied about rhombus and its properties. What is the property related to its diagonals? The diagonals are perpendicular bisectors. The diagonals are the perpendicular bisectors. So for constructing this, first of all, we are going to draw the diagonal AC. First of all, we are going to draw the diagonal AC of length. AC of length?
6 centimeter.
So first of all, we have to draw the diagonal AC. AC of length 6 centimeter. AC of length 6 centimeter. And we know that the diagonals are perpendicular bisectors of each other. What do you mean by perpendicular bisectors of each other? What do you mean by perpendicular bisector? Perpendicular bisector means it divides the other diagonal into two equal parts. And also the angle between them is 90 degree. Okay. So first of all, we have drawn we have to draw the diagonal AC. What is the length of the AC?
6 centimeter.
There is slight change in your textbook. That is, first draw diagonal AC is equal to 7 centimeters given in your textbook, but we have in our question AC is equal to 6 centimeter and BD is equal to 7 centimeter. Don't get confused. Okay, there is some change in your textbook. So first of all, we have drawn AC of length 6 centimeter and we know that AC and BD are the diagonals of the rhombus. And also, what is the property of diagonals of a rhombus? They are perpendicular bisectors of each other. So first of all, we have to mark the middle of AC. That is, at the point 3 centimeter, we can mark the middle. And we know that the other diagonal bisects this diagonal into two equal parts. So the other diagonal will pass through our middle point. And what should be the length of the second diagonal? What should be the length of the second diagonal? It should be 7 centimeter. And this also, the above AC is 3.5 centimeter, and the below AC is also 3.5 centimeter. Did you get? That's we have said in using the properties of diagonal. Diagonals are perpendicular bisectors. So this is 3.5 centimeter. 3.5 centimeter, and again, this is also 3.5 centimeter. And here we can write it as 3 centimeter. 3 centimeter, and this is also 3 centimeter. Is it clear? Is it clear? So we have given only what we have given. We have to construct a rhombus ABCD in which AC is given as 6 centimeter and BD is given as 7 centimeter. As we have drawn our rough sketch, we can get it as both AC and BD are diagonals of a rhombus. And we know that what is the property of diagonals of a rhombus? The diagonals of rhombus should be perpendicular bisectors of each other. That's why first of all we have drawn the line AC or the diagonal AC having length 6 cm, and we know that the second diagonal would be the perpendicular bisectors. That's why we have to draw the second diagonal BD of length 7 cm, which would pass through the middle point of AC. Okay, did you get the idea? Okay, then now we have to construct our rhombus. Now how will we construct our rhombus? We just have to join all the vertices. We have the four vertices A, B, C, D. Now for constructing our rhombus, we just have to join A and B, B and C, C and D, and A and D. That is AB, BC, CD, and AD. This is the required rhombus. Okay. Then, which are the two special cases we have learned? Construction of square and construction of rhombus. Is it clear? The construction of rhombus and the construction of square. So you have an exercise 4.5 is given in page number 68, and there is four questions given for you. Draw the following. First one, the square READ with RE equal to 5.1 cm. A rhombus whose diagonals are 5.2 cm and 6.4 cm long. A rectangle with adjacent sides of length 5 cm and 4 cm. A parallelogram OKAY where OK is equal to 5.5 cm and KA equal to 4.2 cm. Is it unique? You know how to draw square and rhombus. Is it? First two questions, you know how to draw square and rhombus. Then what about a rectangle? Do you able to draw a rectangle? You know how to draw a square. Square is a special type of rectangle. What is the difference between square and rectangle? Square is also a rectangle, is it? A rectangle having equal sides, that we call it as square. So you know how to find the how to draw a square. In this case, we have given two adjacent sides, that is 5 cm and 4 cm long. As we know, the measure of angle of a rectangle should be 90 degrees each. So we can construct that rectangle as in the case of a square. And what's our fourth question? A parallelogram OK where OK is equal to 5.5 cm and KA is equal to 4.2 cm. Is it unique? How will you draw a parallelogram? Parallelogram is also a quadrilateral. Is it? And we have learned how to construct a quadrilateral. Here we have the length of the two sides is given as OK is equal to 5.5 cm and KA is equal to 4.2 cm. Let's check how will you draw this parallelogram. Okay. We have to draw the parallelogram. Okay. For that, first of all, we have to draw our rough sketch. I'm just going to draw our rough sketch. That is, this is the parallelogram OKAY. Don't read it as OK. OKAY. Y. Then what is the length of OK? What is the length of OK? What is the length of OK? The length of OK is given as 5.5 centimeter. 5.5 centimeter. Then what about KA? 4.2 centimeter. Then how will you draw this parallelogram? We don't know about its angle. Do you know about its angle? No. Then how will you draw this parallelogram? How will you draw this parallelogram? From where we have to start? From where we have to start here? We have the rough sketch, and among them we know the values of OK and KA, and we know that the opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal and parallel. Then what is the length of AY? What is the length of AY? What is the length of AY here? Here OK is equal to 5.5 centimeter. AY is the opposite angle, sorry, opposite side. Then what is AY? What is AY?
5.5 centimeter.
It's again 5.5 centimeter. It's again 5.5 centimeter. Then what about KA? What about KA?
4.2
KA is given as 4.2. Then what about OY? It's again 4.2 centimeter. And now we have got all the measures of all the sides of a parallelogram. Is it enough to draw a parallelogram? All of you, please draw a parallelogram having sides 4.2 and 5.5 centimeter in your notebook. You just draw a parallelogram of sides 5.5 and 4.2 in your notebook. All of you.
Miss, is this paper?
Yes, you can do it in your notebook. For drawing a parallelogram, what we have given here? Pair of adjacent sides, is it? That is 5.5 centimeter and 4.2 centimeters are given. Then I am just asking to draw a parallelogram of sides 5.5 centimeter and 4.2 centimeter. Okay, Sean, did you complete it? No, why? Why? We know that what's a parallelogram? A parallelogram is a four-sided polygon or a quadrilateral having opposite sides equal and parallel. It's very important, it's equal and parallel. Don't forget it's parallel. And the opposite side should be 5.5 centimeter and 4.2 centimeters each. Okay. Ijaz, did you complete it? Okay, then show me. Okay. Do it first. We have only 10 more minutes remaining. Okay, complete it. Shreya, then show me. Make it more closer. Okay, I can't get it clear. So after this class, you just have to put your photograph into your groups, class group. Okay, and looking at all the parallelogram, you can decide is it unique or not. Okay, just what is the angle of your parallelogram? What is the angle? What is the angle between O? What is the angle K here? What is the measure of angle K in your parallelogram? Everybody, what is the measure of angle K? What is the measure of angle K? You just measure it and unmute and say. You just unmute and see. How much is it? Angle K. You just unmute and see. What about it? Just
55 degree.
Okay, what about Sean and Shreya? Is it the same? No. That is our next question. Is it unique? The parallelogram may not be unique. It may be different because we don't know what is the correct angle. We don't given the angle. We only have the opposite sides or the two adjacent sides. So while drawing a parallelogram only using the sides, we will get different types of parallelogram that may not be unique. That is our fourth question. Okay. So question numbers 1, 2, and 3, you can do it as your homework. Fourth one we have already discussed. Okay. And after that, there is a small session. What have we discussed? 5 measurements can determine a quadrilateral uniquely. So, look at your fourth question. Here we have only 4 measures are given, is it? There is no other fifth measure. So, we have only 4 measure is given. In this case, we can't get the unique quadrilateral. We will get the unique quadrilateral only if all the 5 measures are given. That's our first point. First, 5 measurements can determine a quadrilateral uniquely. Okay. 5 measurements can determine a quadrilateral uniquely. Then second one. A quadrilateral can be constructed uniquely if the length of its 4 sides and a diagonal is given. And also, A quadrilateral can be constructed uniquely if its 2 diagonals and 3 sides are known. And again, a quadrilateral can be constructed uniquely if its 2 adjacent sides and 3 angles are known. And also, a quadrilateral can be constructed uniquely if its 3 sides and 2 included angles are given. We have studied all the 4 cases and again, one more case, that is the special cases. In the case of a square and a rhombus, we don't need all the 5 measurements in the case of a square and rhombus, because in the case of a square, we know that the angles are all the angles are 90 degree and the sides are equal. And again, in the case of a rhombus, we know that the sides are equal and also the diagonals would perpendicular bisectors of each other. Okay, this is our 4th chapter and it is over. And we have to conduct an examination for both 2nd chapter and 3rd chapter. That is understanding quadrilateral and the practical geometry. Actually, it is about quadrilaterals and its construction. It's very simple. Both chapters are very short and you can find it easily. Okay. Then we have to decide the date for our examination. Is this a suitable day for you? It's about two chapters, then you will decide according to the content. The exam is for the both chapter 3 and 4. Just please unmute and say.
Miss Sindhishta.
Okay, what about Ijaz? Is Sunday possible? Yes. And about time? Evening. What about others? Is there any priority for prayer time? What should be your prayer time in Sundays?
Morning.
Morning. Okay. Then there is nothing in the evening session, okay? So shall we conduct in our evening? About 7 to 8. It's all about 7 to 8. Okay, inform others. I will give an message in your class group. And also you have to inform your friends, okay? So we have to just revise our chapter. That is, in our previous chapter, we have discussed about some quadrilaterals, which are them parallelogram, rhombus, rectangle, square, and kite. What do you mean by a parallelogram? What do you mean by a parallelogram? What is the specialty of a parallelogram?
Each opposite sides are parallel.
Opposite sides should be parallel and equal. And what about its angles? What about its angles?
Opposite angles are equal.
Opposite angles are equal. And what is the sum of its angles? Sum of its angles should be 360 degree, as we know in the case of a quadrilateral. Okay, then what is the angle sum property? We have learned about polygons in the starting of that lesson. And what is the angle sum property of a polygon? If a polygon having n side, then what is the sum of its angles?
N minus 2 into 180.
N minus 2 into 180. So it is the angle sum property of polygons. Then what do you mean by a polygon? What do you mean by a polygon?
Simple closed curve.
It's a simple closed curve made up of line segments.
Only line segment.
Simple closed curve made up of line segments are known as polygon. And we have discussed about some types of polygons. Which are the types of polygons we have discussed? Regular polygon, irregular polygon, and convex polygon and concave polygons and so on. What do you mean by regular polygon? What do you mean by regular polygon? If the length of every sides are equal for a polygon, then we can call it as a regular polygon. Otherwise, it is called irregular polygon. And the same case, what about convex and concave polygons? In the case of convex polygons, what about its vertices?
Vertices pointing outwards.
Yes, vertices are pointing outward in convex polygon. And the vertices, some of its vertices may be
inward.
Pointed in inward in the case of concave polygons. And after that, we have discussed about some special or some types of quadrilaterals. The first quadrilateral was trapezium. What is a trapezium? What is the specialty of a trapezium? What is the specialty of a trapezium? One pair of opposite sides should be parallel for this trapezium. Trapezium is a quadrilateral having one pair of opposite sides should be parallel. Okay, then what about kite? What about kite? Kite is also quadrilateral having? Having?
Two adjacent lines equal.
Two adjacent sides should be equal for kites. Okay. Then what about parallelogram? As we have already said, a parallelogram is a quadrilateral having opposite sides equal and parallel. And we have discussed some properties of a parallelogram. What are the properties of a parallelogram? What about its sides?
Its opposite should be equal.
Opposite side should be equal. Then what about opposite side should be equal and parallel? And what about its opposite angles? Opposite angle should be always equal. And what about the adjacent angles? The adjacent angles are supplementary or linear pairs. The sum of the adjacent angle should be 180 degree. Then there is one more property regarding to the diagonal of a parallelogram. What is the property regarding to the diagonals of a parallelogram? That should be bisecting each other, not perpendicularly, only bisecting each other. In the case of rhombus, it is perpendicular bisectors. Okay. Then after that, we have discussed about rhombus. Rhombus is a special type of parallelogram having all the sides are equal. In the case of rhombus, the diagonals are perpendicular bisectors of each other. That is, they will divide it into perpendicularly, into equal parts. And after that, we have discussed about squares. What do you mean by rectangle? Rectangle is also a special type of parallelogram having all the angles 90 degree. And also, if all the sides and angles are equal, then we can call it as a rhombus. Square. Okay, that's enough in our third chapter. And our fourth chapter is about practical geometry. It's very simple construction of quadrilaterals in different cases. So we have learned four different cases, and after that, one special case in the case of special cases regarding to square and rhombus. That's enough. Yes, Sean.
Miss Avasana, Mr. Homework and Lerno. Exercise 4.5 will have
1, 2, and 3.
Okay.
Okay, that's enough.